If you miss any of that information, you can find it in the menu. Okay, now we are going to try to install the video card. So I pulled the rail out and I have the video card. Now the only slot that you can install the video card is going to be slot 1, which is from 1 to 3, 4. Now this video card also needs aux power. So you have attached aux power cables and you can remove from the chassis and connect. Okay, if you use the 5800 NVIDIA, you will have to also use a baffle, and all the information about that you can find in the menu. The other thing that you have to remember is to screw the bracket to the carrier of the video card. So after we're done with that video card, all you have to do is just push the carrier back in the chassis and use the thumb screws to attach the carrier so it doesn't come out by itself. Okay, so at this point you are ready to install the IPAS cable by 16 power and also your RJ45 to the network. Okay, using here for this demo is actually quite long. I believe this is 7 meters, but you are using 1 meter cable, so that's how it looks. And what you have to do is make sure that you connect this end to the chassis. The other thing that you will be connecting is a network cable. And the last part that will be connecting is your power cable. In this case, we are using our host board, and this is one of the servers, and the host board is attached to one of the slots of the server, and all we have to do is just take this by 16 IPAS cable. And since we are using video cards, of course we have to attach the monitor cable as well. So as Julia mentioned right at the beginning, there are two redundant power supplies, and the very first thing that we have to do before we power on the whole system is to turn on both power supplies, and then we will turn on the main button here. You should see if everything is working okay. All the LEDs should be in color green. Now is there any problem, if there's any problem with operation, the LEDs will turn into red color or amber color on the power supply. So after you powered up the extension chassis, now you go ahead and power up the server. So there are some LEDs, diagnostic LEDs, that starts flashing. In this case, the diagnostic LEDs are actually showing you whether you are connected, whether the slots are trained to by 16 or anything lower than the slots are actually built, and whether the cable is actually also passing PCI Express signal. So those LEDs here are indicating that you have a link. Now, they also blink and depending on the blinking, you can find out information about whether the PCI Express link is Gen 1 or Gen 2, and whether the card or the link trained to the maximum possible number of lanes. So because we have attached the video card to slot number 1, which is by 16, the video card is also by 16, and this video card is capable of running Gen 2, you see that the LED under close to S1 6 screen is solid. Now if and that indicates that this is Gen 2, PCI Express Gen 2. Now if the link was anything lower than by 16, however still Gen 2, then that this LED would be blinking about half a second. The other LED is in, and this LED is telling you about what kind of link, what kind of connection you have on the cable. In this case, because the server is Gen 1 only, we see that this LED is blinking, I believe, 1 second on and half a second off. That means that it's by 16. It would be reversed if it was still Gen 1, but anything lower than the maximum capability of that link. Well, we decided that we wanted to install a NIC card because this is hot swappable system, a hot pluggable system. However, we still need a device that is plugged into the slot before the server boot up. So we'll install this card after we power off the chassis, and then we'll demonstrate the hot plug ability of this chassis while the system is running. So I'm installing the NIC card into slot 3. Again, the slot numbering are in clockwise position, so you have number 1, number 2, number 3, number 4. You can read that information from the top. This is all silk screen here on the top of the carrier. So I installed the card. I have to remember to install the screw, and
currently we're running OpenSUSE 11. To see if the cards are installed, you can run the command lspci-t. As you can see this right here, we have a 4-slot chassis, so they're chassis of this root port with each of their 4-slot installed. Okay.
Hear him.
Another option is to run lspci-v. And you can actually see for our chassis, we're using PLX chipset. So you can actually see PLX technology. Those are the 4-slot inside the chassis. And if you scroll down, this is actually the NVIDIA video card, which is up 03, which is right here. And then we also have an Ethernet controller under 04, which is right over here. Okay. To show you that the video card is working in the chassis, we're going to run a demo through the NVIDIA video card. This demo is called Mad Demo. So as you can see, the demo is running off the video card in the chassis. And it runs pretty fast.
Okay. That's good. Pretty fast.